फ्रेंड्स वेलकम बैक। सेकेंड सेशन वी टॉक्ड अबाउट रेफरेंसिंग एंड डी रेफरेंसिंग द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ पॉइंटर्स। इन दिस पार्ट वी हैव अ लुक एट पॉइंटर टाइप्स बेस्ड ऑन देयर एसोसिएशन। रिमेंबर स्केलिंग फैक्टर, रिमेंबर एसोसिएशन, दैट्स व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, पॉइंटर टाइप्स बेस्ड ऑन एसोसिएशन। नाउ फ्रेंड्स, यू नो व्हेन आई से पॉइंटर टाइप्स, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू यू थिंक? Do you think I am talking about different types of pointers, or am I talking about pointer types based on address? Let's go on and learn. Apart from that, we will also talk about void pointer, a pointer that is, you know, that comes as a question in so many interviews and tests. So we'll have a look at that also. Okay, friends. So let's go on with it.
As I suppose say P equal to ampersand X, when I'm saying this, P is holding the address of X. P is of the same type as X, isn't it? Got it? Although pointer, when I look at pointer, when I look at the variable, assuming X is a variable of sort type, P will be a pointer of sort type, isn't it? But what will be the basic difference between the two? X, for X, the data type is sort. But for P, the data type is not sort. Remember that. Pointers do not have a data type. Universally, all the pointers have a single data type, that is hexadecimal address. So that is the data type which a pointer will have. But then why we write, when we declare, why do I write this? Sort P. Why do I write this? I could have written only, you know, hex P or something like that. Why do I then go for this? This is for the pointer P. Sort is the association type. It is associated to a sort type variable. It can be associated to a sort type variable. That simply means the scaling factor for P will be the size of X. X, the size is 2 bytes, sort integer. So this, whenever P tries to read something from a location, value from a location, it will read 2 bytes. This is where it is very, very important. Understand this point and you will not have much problem in translating pointers. Alright, so got this. Now let's look at an example. Let's look at the very first example which will tell us how exactly this addressing is done. Look at it. Look at the example. You have a float variable having a value 12.345676. Then I say value at P equal to address of X, the referencing. P references X, P gets the address of X. Where is a star P, it will read from that location. And look at that rough diagram. The location where P is, the location where X is having a value, look at the location, imaginary of course, 65528 is the location. Now P gets that address 65528, and from that location it will read the value. And mind it, to read the value it has to read how many bytes? What is the size of float? Try and recall. 4 bytes of course. So now P has got a scaling factor. Just now I was explaining you the same thing. P has got a scaling factor of how many bytes? 4 bytes. That simply means to get the value, P has to read the entire 4 bytes. Got it? If it does not read the 4 bytes, it will not get that entire value, the value part and the mantissa part completely. Got it? This is a simple example of pointer association with variable. And understand that, you know, it is extremely important that you understand the association type is important. Now to what if my association type is different? Supposing I have a sort type pointer, okay, or let's say I have a character type pointer. Because in the next slide I'll show you that kind of example. Before that, I'm just telling you character type pointer, and I have got a sort type variable, sort X equal to 10. Can I say P equal to ampersand X? Can I? Well, on some compilers, it might give you a problem. On some compilers, it will be absolutely fine. P can take that as an X. Amazing, isn't it? But that happens. But what will happen? Try to imagine what will happen if I do a thing like this. Got it? Look at the slide first, then I'll explain. I have the variable, sort variable. Okay, the same example which I was taking. Okay, sort type variable having a value, and the pointer gets the address of X. Now with you say star P, what you will get? You know, this variable, the value of the variable is spread across how many bytes? 2 bytes. But character type pointer, what is the size of a character? 1 byte, of course. So P has a scaling factor of 1 byte. That means whenever you try to dereference through P, whenever you say star P, it will, from the location where it is pointing, it will try and read only 1 byte. Will you get the entire value if you read 1 byte? Because remember, the value is spread across 2 bytes. It is taking 2 bytes of space. So when you read 1 byte out of it, you will get what kind of a value? It will be a pure garbage value, isn't it? So it is very, very important to understand, you know, pointer type and value type should be, data type and pointer type should be same. Data type of the variable should be same as the pointer type of the variable. Repeat again, data type of the variable has to be same as the pointer type of the variable. This is extremely, extremely important. Understand that. But, you know, problem is, if I have a pointer of certain type, I have to have a variable of that type only. Got it? Isn't it a bit, monotonous? I need a pointer of the same type if I have a variable of that type. But, you know, we have something called a void pointer. You must have used it, you must have heard about it. The pointer is called a void type pointer. That simply means the association type. This is how I declare it, void asterisk p. That simply means p is a pointer of which type? Void type. Void, does it have a size? No. So I'll say then, what will be the size of p? Don't worry, p is a pointer and every pointer has a universal size. If it is 16-bit addressing, for example, if you are using Turbo C compiler, it will be, pointer size will be 2 bytes because it is 16-bit addressing. If it is 32-bit addressing, pointer size will be 4 bytes. So p size of p will always be either 2 bytes or 4 bytes. Don't worry about that. But what about the association type? Association type is void, na? So what will be the scaling factor? So I get confused. I say, what is the scaling factor? There is nothing called scaling factor here because void doesn't have a size. Got it? This is where void pointer comes into play as a very important pointer. Problems are there with void pointer, but since it is generic in nature, it is very, very useful. Generic means what? It can point at any data type. It can simply point at any data type. Okay, a void pointer. And I can use it also. Don't worry, I'll show that to you. Now, look at this first slide. This will tell you how to use a void pointer in a particular program. Have a look. X is a sort type variable. X is a sort type variable having a value 25. Y is a float type variable. Okay, Y is a float type variable. What is the value in Y? Inside Y, 345.8796, like that. Char CH is a character type variable having a value A, single character. and look at that line where I declare three different pointers P, Q and R, and each of them assign the address of X, Y and CH respectively, and then I have a printf to print a message. What will happen if I run this program? Will it run? The big question is that. Yes, of course, it will compile and run successfully without any problem. Got it? P gets the address of X, Q, Y and R, CH. No problem with it. As I told you just a few moments before, that a void pointer can point at any type of variable. That means it can keep the address of any type of variable. So no problem at all. X, Y and R, X, Y and CH, all the three of them are different types of variables. But P, Q and R, all the three of them are void pointers, so they are keeping the address. Absolutely no problem with it. Got it?
Okay. So I hope you understood, in case it's a void pointer, in case we are talking about a void pointer can keep the address of any type of a value, any type of a variable. But when we start using it, what will happen? Because before I show you the example, just try and imagine. As I said, P is a void pointer. P will keep the address of any kind of a variable. But when it tries to read the variable, what it requires? Try and recall. It requires a scaling factor, which is missing from a void type pointer. Isn't it? Look at this example quickly.
I have just extended the previous example. The three variables are there, X, Y and CH. P, Q and R are having the address of these three variables. Okay. And then I am trying to print the value of P, value at P, value at Q and value at R. Got it? Star P, star Q and star R. Will it print the values? What do you think? Will it print the values? No. Simply because, as we discussed, no scaling factor. Void is association type, means no scaling factor. So how can P go to that location? P is pointing at a variable. Okay. How can P go to that location where the variable is present? If it goes to the location, even then it goes to that location, but how many bytes to read? That is a big question. How many bytes to read? 2 bytes, 4 bytes, 8 bytes, how many bytes to read? How will it know? Got it? So that is the issue over here when it comes to a void pointer. So what is to be done? How can I use it? Because see, we said void pointer is advantageous. Just imagine you can have a single pointer in a program. Here we are taking an example with multiple pointers. Just imagine P, the single pointer. P will first point at X, then Y, then CH, like that. It can be done. But how to use it? How can we use it? Because we are saying it doesn't have a scaling factor. What we do over there, the solution is we typecast the pointer when using it. While trying to dereference the pointer, we need to cast it, and it will be purely temporary. For that particular statement, for that particular dereferencing, it will tell the compiler for every period that this pointer need to be converted into character type, float type or double type. That is how you do it. So here in this example which I just now shown you, this program, when you try to compile it, there itself it will give you errors. Why? Because you are directly trying to dereference a void pointer, which is not possible. So how can I do it? Through, as I said, through typecasting. Look at this particular example, how it is typecasted. Okay, look at the casting. The first one, look at the first printf statement. Other lines are same till that giving the address of X, Y and CH to P, Q and R. That line, till that line the code is same. look at the printf statement, the first printf, x equal to percentile d. Look at what I am doing. Star p, just after the asterisk, in bracket I write short star, that is the casting. Okay, short star is the casting. That means I am asking the compiler to temporarily convert p into a short type pointer. That means p will automatically get a scaling factor of the size of short, that is 2 bytes for that particular statement. That is casting. Second statement, I am casting it to a float, and the third one, casting it to a character. Accordingly, 4 bytes of scaling factor, 1 byte of scaling factor. Got it? So this is how I cast a void pointer. Got it? Very, very useful, friends. When you use a void pointer, mind it is very, very useful, very, very important void pointer. But you know, this typecasting, of course, you know, you have to, every time you use it, you have to typecast it. Got it? So friends, here in this session, we discussed how to work with, of course, we discussed about pointer type and variable type, the match, and we looked at it, we said, you know, pointer type, variable type should be same. If not same, then I can use a void pointer, but with restriction. The restriction is, it has to be typecasted. Got it, friends? Let's keep it till this point. You know, void pointer, till void pointer we have discussed. In the next session, we will go more deeper into pointers. Okay, we'll look at some more concepts. We start looking at the use of pointers with functions. Inside functions, how can I use a pointer? Okay, what are the nitty-gritties? Alright, so I keep it here. Friends, please, if you are new, if you are watching this for the first time, please do. Subscribe to my channel, please share, please like, and please leave your comments. And of course, starting from the next session, we'll have a trivia question for you. Okay, in the next video, after that, the video after that, we'll discuss the answer to that trivia question. If you have the answer, please do come up with the answer. Please do, you know, keep the answer in the comment section. It will be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Thank you all.